So next to Nicole, we have Clay Stidham. Did I say that right?
Close enough.
Okay. My name is Isella, so I get it. Blue Ridge Unified School District Director of Curriculum, Instruction, and Assessment, and one of the most awesomest people I know. Then we have Donna Bateman, who is at Copper King Elementary School, is a kindergarten teacher who has been implementing our practices this school year, has been teaching for a long time, but first time in kindergarten. And then we have Diana Valls from Galvanize Phoenix. She's the general manager. And when we were thinking about who else to bring, who's an important component, we needed to bring someone in from the tech world, because so much of what we are seeing in terms of the future is in and around technology and what we need to do to provide the best foundations for children who are going to grow up and enter the workforce. Okay, so these are the questions. We have them here, right, Veronica?
Yes.
All right, so first question for Nicole. As schools become more engaged in the process of supporting the whole child, what systems and or processes do you believe are necessary in shifting how we have historically approached teaching and learning?
When I think about the question that you asked, Isella, I was thinking, oh my gosh, it's such a big question. And it sort of goes along with what we saw in that film where he said, education is big, it's complex, it's messy. And so when I think about systemic changes that have to happen, I think about it in that way. And there are two things that I thought of when you asked the question. And the first thing I thought is that when we think about systemic work, what does it mean to be part of a system? That's a very easy road to get lost on. People think systems work and they think the whole system has to move at once and lose sight of the processes that make up the parts of the system. And what I mean by that is, take for instance, third grade reading. How many of you are aware of that we have a third grade reading law, right? Everybody knows our focus is on third grade reading. How many of us know how complex a thing it is to learn how to read? We hold up AZ merit scores and we say, that third grade, they're not reading this, this, and then this should happen. If we flip that and we said, third grade reading matters, and it matters for many, many reasons. Can we go back to when this child is in the womb and then comes out of that womb, what are we doing to prepare them to do this very unnatural thing we call reading? And I say it's unnatural because it's the thing our brain is not pre-wired to do. Our brain is pre-wired to acquire language. And so if we look at infants and we say, okay, so if we're gonna get to third grade reading, I have to back up and go to infants. What does an infant need that will prepare them to become a reader? They need a lot of language experiences. They need people to talk with them, to talk around them, to use sophisticated language that they learn to become sophisticated users of language. They do that in the context of relationships. They don't, if you take a baby, you put that baby out into the middle of the trees and never interact with that baby never picks up language. Because although they are pre-wired for language, it happens in the context of an exchange or a relationship with a person. Well, what does that mean when they have relationships? Well, that means they have to care about their social-emotional development. And not only of the child, but of the adult, the other child, the person they're having an exchange with, I have to care about their social-emotional development. So it's not just about language. Now I've got social-emotional development. When I start putting those pieces together, it prompts me to start thinking about mathematically. That means I have to understand how the parts affect the whole. And you start thinking about language in that way. So all of these things equal third grade reading. That's very complex. It's very messy. If we said that, instead of saying AZ merit scores are low and we've got to get them up, and we said, oh my gosh, all the things that lead to third grade reading, we need to pay attention to. And it's not me and it's not you, it's you and I, plus him, plus her. Every person who interacts with the child contributes to what they do in third grade as it relates to reading. So that's a very complex thing, but it's the thing that has to be held up. And then the second thing that I thought about was, he talked about the average. And they talked about that a little bit, I think it was Rod Friedman that was saying, we have average everything. I think one of the things that we have to do is dispel this myth that there is such a thing as an average. There's this really fantastic book out right now, I encourage you to read it. It's called The End of Average, and it's by Todd Rose. Phenomenal book, because it tells us all that we understand about averages is wrong. We have been led to believe that there is an average student, there's an average way to do something. We can come to solutions that work if we determine an average. And there's no such thing as an average, because every person is different, every person in a system is different, every system is different from a different system. We saw that in the movie. They said, between the schools who do like work, very, very different what you see, because there is no average way to do this.